Hello and welcome to Gearheads. My name's Jesse, and today get out your flame suits and get out your tissues because I'm sure there's gonna be a whole lot of people out there butt hurt and upset because we're gonna be talking crap about Harbor Freight. Now, I will start off defending and saying I really like Harbor Freight, like this toolbox I got from them and a lot of the tools that I actually do use every day. I did buy from Harbor Freight. They have some good stuff there, and they have also dramatically improved the quality over the last 10 years or so since I started buying tools there. I remember a lot of the things they had back then, some of the newer stuff I've seen come along, and some of the other things that have been improved upon. So, and I already did a couple videos on tools that I really like from there and highly recommend to people. So if you haven't seen them, feel free to go check them out so you don't think I hate everything from Harbor Freight. But this list is just a quick five item list. It's not exactly in any specific order, so. Anyways, watch out if there's a little bit of vulgarity in this one, because I'm gonna be talking some shit about these things. I hate a lot of these tools. I also don't have all these tools to physically show you in my hand, because guess what? I'm not gonna go buy them. I've already bought them once, or maybe twice, a couple of them, and broken them, or they just didn't work well, and I threw them in the garbage, because that's what they were, hot garbage. I didn't want to keep them anymore. So let's go and get started with the first thing on the list, and that is their snap ring pliers. It's gonna be the cheaper set that they sell. I also had the kit that they sell that you can swap the heads on, so you can change the direction the snap ring pliers go, or you can put different tips on them. I'm sorry, I understand maybe to a hobbyist or somebody that's using them for smaller things, it might work fine, but almost every single time I have used these for automotive use and been trying to take some of them apart, they either always are slipping because they're made and they're all shaky, they don't work good, and they break all the time. I've broken a few of them, I'm not gonna use them anymore. You know what? The Snap-on guy here, I actually went without any of my own for like 2 years because I kept forgetting to just buy some, and I just would go and borrow one of the other guys in the shops, whether it was this shop or the last shop I worked at. I would just go borrow some when I needed them. Snap-on guy came by the other day. He had a really good promo on the actual Snap-on branded ones, and he gave them to me for a really good price. So I bought a full set of those, and I love them. So I'm not really trying to compare Snap-on to Harbor Freight on that one because the Snap-on ones are completely different design. It's a full dedicated set, not one with swappable heads like the Harbor Freight one. And obviously the Harbor Freight one's very cheap. So maybe for some hobby, you know, hobbyist use for small things, but for automotive use, no. They suck donkey dick. Get something better. Next one up. I actually do have this still, one of them at least, in the toolbox to show you. Where is it? I actually do have one more of these left in my toolbox from all the other ones that I'd broken and thrown out. And this is the Harbor Freight swivel adapters. It's like the ball socket universal joint. Now, very good idea, and I love high quality versions of these. Like, I have a full set of swivel sockets that I bought on the Matco truck, and I will show you the difference and why the Harbor Freight ones suck so bad. So one of these is just going to be the universal joint style, like this one's an adapter and this one's an actual socket, but either way you'll get the point, because if I also have a set of these Matco ones that's adapters like this also. Now, if you're using hand tools, these, you know, swivel adapters often are very difficult to use, especially if you put it straight on the ratchet, because they I don't know, a lot of people don't like them. I've heard it from that from a lot of people, and I understand why if you're using a hand ratchet. If you're using an electric ratchet, or if you have it on a gun, then swivels and, you know, ball swivel ones like this are the best. They work so awesome. But not the Harbor Freight ones, because they have this design where, let me just show you up close. So you can see the ball in there, and it's got a single rod going through the middle to hold that ball in place. And then what's holding that rod is just this spring. That's the only thing holding the thing together. Now, I'm sure if you wanted to get creative, you could probably come up with some kind of decent solution to this and make them actually work well. The problem is, you put these things on a gun or a ratchet and it's moving quickly and it's hitting hard on something and vibrating a lot. This spring comes loose, that the rod in there comes loose and falls out, and this thing will either seize up or fly apart. And you have this thing behind a high powered gun that's moving fast, or you're hitting on something real hard and it suddenly breaks loose like that. Things can go flying, things can break, you can get hurt if you're not being careful, and I don't recommend them at all. It's not worth it. They're cheap, but cool. You can buy better design ones online for a good price that don't have this crappy spring holding them in place that will actually work and last a lot better. I tried a few of the swivel socket versions of these, and I also tried a couple different of the adapters that they sell like this, and all of them, except for this one, because I stopped using them by this point, started to fall apart. I at first saw them there and I was like, oh, they're really cheap, that'd be a good deal. And I kept having to fix it, kept having to put the spring back in place. One of them, I just didn't have another option at that moment, from my own toolbox at least. And the universal joints, I don't like using those very much at all. I much prefer the ball swivel style ones like this. But one of them, the spring broke or came off, and I ended up fixing it with a zip tie temporarily, and I just used that to finish that job and threw that one out. So I have this one around, I guess, just in case, but let me show you the version that I have that I like a lot better and why I think it's a lot better. So this is my ADV one that I got off the Matco truck, and you can see it's a very similar design with the ball there, and it's got the rod going through the middle. However, it has this nice pressed on strong metal collar to hold that in place. I have been using these behind half inch and 3/8 guns for the last year and a half now, and I haven't broken a single one. Oh, okay, you know what, I'm wrong. Actually, I did damage my 18 millimeter one once, but guess what, they warrantied out on the truck for free. Not a big problem. And the truth is, these are 3/8. I was using an adapter. I should buy a half inch set of these eventually. Right now I only have 3/8 and 1/4 inch. But besides the point, it's just a different design. They've held up a lot better. And I can't be mad at least about the 3/8 one breaking behind a big half inch gun that I was hitting on real hard for a while. It didn't break actually. What happened is the rod here kind of dug into that ball a little bit. So as another option for somebody else looking for something like this, you don't have a tool truck that comes to you, or you're at home but you want to get a set of these things because they're awesome, they're some of my favorite tools, go online, look at the Sun-X ones. I believe Sun-X is made in the same factory as the ADV ones that these are. So these are not the actual Matco brand, it's their it's like their budget brand or whatever. But anyway, those have been awesome and I really love those things. Alright, let's get to the next one. The Pittsburgh pry bars. Pieces of shit. I do not like them at all because they flex so much. You know, you get the pry bar set from them. If you want to use just the small ones that are like maybe this big, then you know what, those ones work fine because you're probably not going to be putting that much load on a pry bar that's that small. But when it's that small, why not just use your strong flathead or something like that? And if you're getting a pry bar set, just don't buy these ones. They are awful. They flex so much, and then when they're flexing, it makes it harder to hold them in place. You're more likely to slip, bust your knuckles, something like that. Not worth it. I have a few other branded ones that I've used, and I do actually have one that I got from Harbor Freight. I'll make sure I at least link it and put it on the screen so you can see which one I'm talking about. And that one's a lot stronger and has worked pretty well for me, and you know, it's nothing crazy to write home about or talk about. It's just a simple pry bar. Difference is, it's a simple pry bar that actually works, unlike the Pittsburgh branded ones that flex like crazy. I bet you I could get it on my knee and bend it, but I don't think I have it here anymore. They're garbage. Don't buy them. Let's move on to the next thing. Socket extensions. You know, if you're only doing things with hand tools and you're not using it behind, you know what, I don't even want to say that because I don't think I even had a chance to break any of them on my electric ratchets. I've never, that I can remember, broken all my electric ratchets, and I definitely didn't put them behind a big gun. I'm pretty sure all of the extensions that I've broken were broken with hand tools, whether it was 1/4 inch or 3/8. I don't have any of the half inch ones. I never bought them from there. But anyway, I have gone through multiple sets of the smaller ones because I figured, oh, maybe after I went through a few of the first set, I thought, oh, maybe I just got unlucky. Maybe these ones were just a bad batch or something. So a few months later, I just needed a few more small extensions, so I went and picked them up. And guess what? Like the first time I used one of the 1/4 inch ones, I had to be using 1/4 inch, and I had a Mercedes that I was working on, and there was one freaking 10 millimeter bolt in this super tight spot, and I could not get it without a 1/4 inch extension on a ratchet. And the first time I used it, it snapped and broke. And I wasn't even putting that much pressure on it. I ended up borrowing a Craftsman one from my boss. That one worked just fine, took it off good. And I have to say, my Husky ones, you know, I don't see why Husky would be better than Harbor Freight in this aspect, but the Husky ones that I've had and have been using for a long time, I haven't broken any of those ones yet. And I haven't broken any of the other random ones I bought. But for some reason, every time I bought these 3/8 and 1/4 inch extensions from Harbor Freight, they always end up breaking. So I do not recommend them. throw them in the garbage, at least for me. And if you use them, they work for you, cool. But I am personally, I'm not a fan of a tool I can't trust. If I'm putting a decent amount of torque on something, the worst thing is when it breaks and then you bust your knuckle and then you're swearing and cussing because you just, you know, now you're bleeding and you're mad and you want to go to lunch, but it's not lunchtime yet. So, all right, next thing on the list. Well, I guess this is the last one because this is only 5 things on this video, but the pulley installer and removal kits. I'm sorry. I have used them before to some varying degrees of success, and they have occasionally worked for me, but not very well, and they seem to break. One time, for example, I had a power steering pulley that I was trying to, I had removed it, and it worked. Sweet. I got the power steering pulley off with the kit. But it didn't work that great. The threads on the puller and installer aren't that good. So I was trying to install the pulley back onto the power steering pump, and what happened as I'm pulling it on there, the bolt that you're using to pull it on snapped, like, right in the power steering pump, and then you're screwed. Because now you have to pull the pump back out, and you have to find a way to hold the pump from spinning and extract the broken bolt out of it, which luckily I was able to do, but not worth your time, not worth the risk, not worth the effort. And the crankshaft one's similar idea. It's just janky. Doesn't work very good. The threads on the bolts they give you are not that great, and I don't like them. So that's about all I got for at least today on this subject. If you guys want to hear some more, you know, more crap about Harbor Freight and tools that I personally have not had a good experience with and don't like, then let me know down in the comments, and maybe I'll come up with another list of items that I have bought from there and had bad experiences with. But I do have to say, most things I get from Harbor Freight are pretty good. Some of them suck ass. So stay away from the ones that people have told you to stay away from, unless you want to give it a shot and find out for yourself. But, you know, there's a lot of other good options out there now, too. You know, Amazon has a lot of good brands and good stuff that they sell. You get it for a good price. It gets shipped to your door in 2 days for free shipping. Good place to go if you can't find what you're looking for at Harbor Freight. So, anyway, if you guys like this video, please leave a thumbs up. If you own any of the tools that I listed in this video and you really like them, then you can leave a thumbs down. I'm sorry. If it's working for you, it's working for you, but they didn't work for me, so that's all I can say. But I hope you guys at least enjoyed it. If you want to see more videos like this, then hit that subscribe button, and I guess that's it for me tonight. Hopefully I'll see you guys again soon, and as always, keep wrenching.